Service teardown, Z2 Mini G4 Workstation PC. Removal. On the rear of the unit, slide the release latch to the release position to partially eject the top cover. Lift the rear edge of the top cover and slide the tabs on the front edge out of the notches in the chassis. Remove the top cover. Replacement. Tow the tabs on the front edge of the top cover into the notches on the chassis and lower into position. Apply pressure to the rear edge of the top cover until the release latch clicks. Before you begin, remove the top cover. Removal. Remove the thermal sensor cable from the routing channel on the SATA cable connector. Pull the blue tab on the SATA cable to disconnect it from the connector on the storage drive. Loosen the captive T15 Torx head screw that secures the storage drive assembly to the heatsink. Swing the storage drive assembly up and remove the tabs on the assembly from the cutouts in the chassis. Remove the storage drive assembly. Replacement. Important, if you are replacing the storage drive, the mounting screws and cage will need to be removed from the old storage drive and attached to the new storage drive. Tow the tabs on the storage drive assembly into the cutouts in the chassis and lower it into position. Tighten the captive T15 Torx head screw that secures the storage drive assembly to the heatsink. Connect the SATA cable into the connector on the storage drive. Route the thermal sensor cable through the routing channel on the SATA cable connector. Before you begin, remove the top cover. Removal. Swing up the CPU fan. Push both arms outward simultaneously to release the memory module to the spring tension position. Grasp the memory module by the edges and pull gently to remove it. Replacement. Align the notch in the memory module with the key in the memory module slot on the motherboard. At an angle, gently insert the memory module into its slot on the motherboard. Press the memory module down to latch the arms. Swing down the CPU fan. Before you begin, remove the top cover. Removal. Swing the CPU fan up until it is perpendicular to the CPU heatsink. Slide the posts on the CPU fan straight up and out of the notches in the CPU heatsink. Disconnect the CPU fan connector from the system board. Remove the CPU fan. Replacement. Connect the fan into the connector to the system board. Slide the CPU fan posts into the slots in the CPU heatsink and swing it into position on the system board. Important, ensure the CPU fan cable is not pinched between the CPU fan and system board components. Before you begin, remove the top cover and 2.5-inch storage drive assembly. Removal. Remove the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the GPU fan to the system board. Swing the GPU fan up until it is perpendicular to the GPU heatsink. Slide the posts on the GPU fan straight up and out of the notches in the GPU heatsink. Disconnect the GPU fan connector from the system board. Remove the GPU fan. Replacement. Connect the fan into the connector to the system board. Slide the GPU fan posts into the slots in the GPU heatsink and swing it into position on the system board. Important, ensure the GPU fan cable is not pinched between the GPU fan and system board components. Replace the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the GPU fan to the system board. Before you begin, remove the top cover and 2.5-inch storage drive assembly. Removal. Important, if a GPU fan is installed, remove the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the GPU fan to the system board. Then swing the GPU fan up and rest it in the open position. Caution, Use care when disconnecting the wireless LAN antenna cables from the wireless LAN module. A damaged cable or connector can degrade performance. Carefully disconnect the wireless LAN antenna cables from the wireless LAN module by grasping the connectors with a small pair of needle-nose pliers or tweezers. Remove the 7mm T9 Torx head screw that secures the wireless LAN module to the system board and allow it to release to the spring tension position. Grasp the wireless LAN module by the edges and pull gently to remove it from the slot on the system board. Replacement. Align the notch in the wireless LAN module with the key in the wireless LAN module slot on the system board. At an angle, gently insert the wireless LAN module into the slot on the system board. Replace the 7mm T9 Torx head screw that secures the wireless LAN module to the system board. Reconnect the wireless LAN antenna cables to the wireless LAN module. Caution! Use care when connecting the wireless LAN antenna cables to the wireless LAN module. A damaged cable or connector can degrade performance. Important! If a GPU fan is installed, swing it down and rest it into position on the system board, then replace the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the GPU fan to the system board. Before you begin, remove the top cover and 2.5-inch storage drive assembly. Removal. Important. If a GPU fan is installed, remove the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the GPU fan to the system board. Then swing the GPU fan up and rest it in the open position. Remove the 7mm T9 Torx head screw that secures the solid-state drive assembly to the system board and allow it to release to the spring tension position. Grasp the solid-state drive assembly by the edges and pull gently to remove it from the slot on the system board. Important! If replacing the solid-state drive, follow these steps. Loosen the captive P1 Phillips head screw that holds the two pieces of the solid-state drive heatsink closed. Separate the two pieces of the solid-state drive heatsink from each other. Make note of the orientation and placement of the solid-state drive in the heatsink for installation of the new solid-state drive. Remove the solid-state drive from the thermal pads on the heatsink. Install a new solid-state drive onto the thermal pads on the heatsink. Attach the two pieces of the solid-state drive heatsink together. Tighten the captive P1 Phillips head screw that holds the two pieces of the solid-state drive heatsink closed. Replacement. Align the notch in the solid-state drive with the key in the solid-state drive slot on the motherboard. At an angle, gently insert the solid-state drive into its slot on the motherboard. Replace the 7mm T9 Torx head screw that secures the solid-state drive to the motherboard. Important! If a GPU fan is installed, swing it down and rest it in position on the system board. Then, replace the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the GPU fan to the system board. Before you begin, remove the top cover and 2.5-inch storage drive assembly. Removal. Remove the two 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the option board to the system board. Lift the rear edge of the option board to disconnect it from the system board. Carefully lift the option board off of the standoffs on the system board and slide it out of the cutout in the chassis. Replacement. Slide the option board into the cutout in the chassis and align the screw holes in the option board with the standoffs on the system board. Press the option board into the connector on the system board. Replace the two 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the option board to the system board. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, and GPU fan. Removal. Press down on the release tab on the speaker bracket to disengage a tab from the chassis. Slide the tabs on the bottom edge of the speaker bracket out of the cutouts in the chassis. Disconnect the speaker cable from the connector on the system board and remove the speaker. Replacement. Connect the speaker cable into the connector on the motherboard. Slide the tabs on the bottom edge of the speaker bracket into the cutouts in the chassis and carefully press it into position on the chassis until it clicks. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, and GPU fan. Removal. Note, the heatsink has numbers adjacent to the following four screws. Loosen the four captive T15 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink to the MXM graphics card in numerical order. Lift the heatsink straight up and off the MXM graphics card and remove it from the chassis. Replacement. Using an alcohol swab, carefully remove the thermal grease from the heatsink and GPU. Apply new thermal grease to the GPU. Inspect the thermal pads on the heatsink to ensure they are properly positioned. If one is torn or otherwise damaged, it needs to be replaced. Align the screws on the heatsink with the screw holes in the MXM graphics card and place the heatsink into position over the GPU. Tighten the four T15 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink to the MXM graphics card in numerical order.
How to replace the MXM graphics card. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, and GPU fan. Removal. Remove the two 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the MXM graphics card to the system board. Lift the left edge of the MXM graphics card, and at an angle, pull gently to remove it from the slot on the system board. Replacement. Align the notch in the MXM graphics card with the key in the slot on the system board. At an angle, gently insert the MXM graphics card into its slot on the system board. Replace the two 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the MXM graphics card to the system board.
Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, wireless LAN module, GPU fan, and CPU fan. Removal. Important, make careful note of the routing of the wireless antenna cables for later replacement. Using a non-metallic, flat-bladed tool, carefully release the upper edge of the main wireless LAN transceiver from the retention clips on the chassis. Slide the tabs on the lower edge of the main wireless LAN transceiver out of the chassis and remove. Remove the aux wireless antenna cable from the routing clip on the chassis. Using a non-metallic, flat-bladed tool, carefully release the upper edge of the aux wireless LAN transceiver from the retention clips on the chassis. Slide the tabs on the aux wireless LAN transceiver out of the chassis and remove. Replacement. Tow the tabs on the lower edge of the aux wireless LAN transceiver into the chassis and apply pressure to the top edge of the transceiver to secure it under the retention clips. Route the aux wireless antenna cable through the routing clip on the chassis. Tow the tabs on the lower edge of the main wireless LAN transceiver into the chassis and apply pressure to the top edge of the transceiver to secure it under the retention clips. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, wireless LAN module, GPU fan, and CPU fan. Removal. Important, make careful note of the routing of the thermal sensor cable for later replacement. Disconnect the thermal sensor cable from the connector on the system board. Remove the thermal sensor cable from the routing channel between the chassis and system board. Remove the thermal sensor cable from the retention clip on the chassis and remove it. Replacement. Connect the thermal sensor cable into the connector on the system board. Route the thermal sensor cable through the routing channel between the chassis and system board. Replace the thermal sensor cable into the retention clip on the chassis. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, and CPU fan. Removal. Note, the heatsink has numbers adjacent to the following three screws. Loosen the three captive T15 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink over the CPU in numerical order. Lift the heatsink straight up and off of the system board and remove it from the chassis. Replacement. Using an alcohol swab, carefully remove the thermal grease from the heatsink and CPU. Apply new thermal grease to the CPU. Inspect the thermal pads on the heatsink to ensure they are properly positioned. If one is torn or otherwise damaged, it needs to be replaced. Align the screws on the heatsink with the screw holes on the system board and place the heatsink into position over the CPU. Tighten the three T15 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink to the system board in numerical order. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, wireless LAN module, GPU fan, CPU fan, and CPU heatsink. Removal. Important: make careful note of the routing of the power button and HDD activity LED cables for later replacement. Disconnect the power button and HDD activity LED cable from the connector on the system board. Remove the HDD activity LED from the retention clips on the chassis. Remove the power button and HDD activity LED cables from the routing channel between the chassis and system board. Press the release tab on the power button bracket to disengage it from the chassis. Remove the power button and HDD activity LED cables. Replacement. Slide the tabs on the bottom edge of the power button bracket into the cutouts in the chassis and carefully press it into position until it clicks. Connect the power button and HDD activity LED cable into the connector on the system board. Insert the HDD activity LED into the retention clips on the chassis. Route the power button and HDD activity LED cables through the routing channel between the chassis and system board. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, CPU fan, and CPU heatsink. Removal. Press down to release the CPU load lever from its retention tab and pull it back. Lift the load plate off the socket. Important: identify the pin 1 triangle on the socket and CPU prior to removing the CPU. Important: when handling the CPU, do not touch the CPU contacts. Carefully lift the CPU straight up and out of the socket. Replacement. Align the pin 1 triangle on the CPU with the pin 1 triangle on the socket. Carefully lower the CPU into position in the socket. Swing the load plate down. Lock the load lever under its retaining tab to secure the CPU in place. Before you begin, remove the top cover, 2.5-inch storage drive assembly, wireless LAN module, M.2 solid-state drive assembly, option board, system speaker, GPU fan, GPU heatsink, MXM graphics card, wireless LAN antennas, CPU fan, thermal sensor, power button and HDD activity LED cable, CPU heatsink, and CPU. Removal. Remove the 9mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the system board to the chassis. Remove the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the system board to the chassis. Important: on some models of this PC, an additional 16mm T15 Torx head screw needs to be removed. Slide the system board toward the front of the chassis and then toward the right side of the chassis to remove the external connectors on the system board from the cutouts in the chassis. Lift the rear edge of the system board and carefully guide it out of the chassis. Remove the system board. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install onto the new system board. Memory boards. CMOS battery. Replacement. At an angle, tow the front edge of the system board into the chassis and lower it onto the chassis. Slide the system board toward the left side of the chassis and then towards the rear of the chassis to insert the external connectors into the cutouts in the chassis. Replace the 16mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the system board to the chassis. Important: on some models of this PC, an additional 16mm T15 Torx head screw needs to be removed. Replace the 9mm T15 Torx head screw that secures the system board to the chassis.